本实例最大的特点是用声音来触发一段程序的执行。The idea in the sketch is to activate a segment of code by sound. 程序刚开始执行时，新建了一个布尔变量 running， 并设置其为假值。接着，在 loop 中不断检查麦克风采集的声音是否超过阈值 mic wow。如果声音小而没有超过阈值，而 running 是假值，于是逻辑或运算的结果为假值， if 结构不能执行。 At the beginning, a new boolean variable running is set to false. In the loop, the sound level collected by the microphone is being continuously checked with the threshold mic wow. If the sound level is below the threshold, while running is false,The result of the logical OR operation is false. The if statement will not run. 此时如果我们拍手，麦克风的数值就能超过阈值800。即使 running 是假值，逻辑或运算的结果就是真值。于是 if 结构中的程序开始执行。If we clap, the sound level may go over 800.The if condition becomes true regardless the variable running is still false because of the logical OR operation. The if statement will be executed. 在 if 结构中，两个 Klebo C6 后脑勺上的红外传感器 TCRT5000 的数值被平均，平均值乘以4后作为扬声器的频率发生。通过再把平均值重新映射后作为嘴上发光二极管的 PWM 信号控制发光二极管的亮度。只要第一次执行了这个 if 结构，布尔变量 running 会因这条负值变成真值。等到下次 loop 循环时， if 条件因为 running 为真值始终被执行。 In the if statementThe value of the two TCRT5000 sensors at the back of Klebo C6 hat is averaged. The averaged value times 4 to be the sound frequency. After remapping, it also acts as the PWM signals for controlling the brightness of the LED. The Boolean variable running is set to true in the first entry to the if statement. So, in the next loop,The if condition is always true, and the value of the TCRT5000 will be continuously sampled to control the sound pitch and the LED brightness. 于是，只要有一次拍手触发了变量 running 状态的改变， Klebo C6 就开始循环检测后方物体的距离。距离越小，声音频率越大，发光二极管越暗。After the first sound activation, the variable running will be set to true permanently, and Klebo C6 goes into a loop, which measures the object distance. The closer, the higher the pitch, and the dimmer the LED.